to give his team the win.
Do you get the idea? Do you sense that we saw the passing of the torch, even a little bit, on Nitro when Bob Bagwell, what a shock that was, Dream, when Bob Daddy got the 1-2-3 on none other than the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Well, I tell you what, I don't know about the passing of the torch. I'm not ready to go ahead and put that thing to bed yet, because I said earlier, old dog, we're fighting. You got to make sure who you're messing with. And I guarantee you, Piper as Vice President, Blair as President. Whoa, what is it? Oh, right here. Chris, young dog right here getting on it.
The Disco Inferno was dancing his way to the ring. Prince Iaukea had had more than enough and jumped Disco in the ring into the area. But Disco, oh, cut him off. And Prince Iaukea belly first into the ring apron. Now into the steel ring steps.
Well, a new attitude, a rougher, harder edge for Prince Iaukea, who does not want to wait for the opening bell. He met Disco up the aisleway, but Disco Inferno has quickly turned the tide in his favor.
He certainly is. Disco taking over. Shoots Iaukea into the turnbuckle. Reversal, and there goes Iaukea one more time. Iaukea getting the grand tour over the top, all the way to the floor.
Disco Inferno is one of them guys that are right on the verge of being great. When I talk about that, I use that, not, you know, I don't throw that around a lot.
No.
But, man, we have seen him in a situation where he's almost there. Take Prince. Let us not forget that Prince was one time the world's television champion. This here is an evenly matched up match, I believe, right here.
And a lot of people, I think, Dusty, are looking back at that eight-man tag team this past Monday on Nitro, and they're thinking that that might be a groundbreaking win for the future of world championship wrestling. And we talk about passing the torch. I don't think it's so much that the future stars of WCW want the established stars to step aside. I think they just want an opportunity.
Well, let me tell you something. The torch is carried. We're not talking about Piper and Flair. The torch is carried when you hold the world's heavyweight title. Each and every man needs to have that on his mind. Kevin Nash, Big Sexy, Sid Vicious, the Macho Man, and what's going down with them? T, Superdome coming up, big party going on. You see the Cowboys are all together right now. You see Jimmy Hart, First Family, back together. Everybody's starting to jockey for position because they see maybe what Malenko says. Let's get it on. Let's start it. When it's all over, then we can say where the torch is passed.
And Kevin Nash is finding out firsthand that when you wear the world's heavyweight championship belt around your waist, that target on your back seems to grow. And Randy Savage shocked the world when he added Sid Vicious to his team.
Disco Inferno now has Prince Iaukea racked, walks right into a big full scoop and slam in the center of the ring. Disco Inferno gives the high sign, dances his way all the way to the second turnbuckle. Iaukea prone almost in the center of the ring. A little wiggle from old DI, gonna drop it straight down on Prince Iaukea. Quickly over, float over, lateral press, hooks the leg, only got the two count.
You know, in the past, the detriment as far as the Disco Inferno seems to be concerned has been his lack of intense concentration during a matchup. Seems to be more focused, however, Dusty, as of late.
Yeah, and focus is the name of the game. When you see guys that are seeing their held down or held back, whoa, got a pin right here. Opportunity is knocking on the door for the Prince right here. Opportunity knocking. They got to stay focused because we've seen somebody's coming for your spot. You know what I'm talking about?
Snap suplex from Prince Iaukea. A battle of former television champions tying up here on the superstation. Took his time to the lateral press and paid the price. He only got the two count.
You make a great point, Scott. Both of these men can relate to the fact that when you wear the championship gold, people are coming at you from every angle. Both former world's TV champions. Momentum trying to get Prince Iaukea over. Oh, blocked it momentarily. Now Disco's got him.
Just paint brushed him out and cradled him up. And again, only got the two count. Iaukea. The kick right under the top of the head of the Disco Inferno.
Here's another thing to think about. When you win a title at an early age, it's hard because maybe momentum carried you. There were circumstances that made you win that title. And now coming back and getting it, we've seen both guys struggle on this comeback to regain a major championship. And sometimes I always say, well, you're young and you win something, that's good, but I'd rather you go in and put your time in, learn what you need to do to win it and keep it. Winning and keeping it, as Big Sexy is finding out right now, is harder, you know what I mean, than maybe when them flash win like might have happened in this situation here.
You're saying that long term for your career, it may be a negative to win a high profile match or a championship belt early in your career, because then it's more difficult to get established down the line once you've lost that belt.
Well, I'll tell you a good example of this. Fires back right here. Oh, little old elbow wasn't bionic. Got another one bionic, would have had it not seen a bionic elbow. I'm going to give you a little situation on that right there. 19 years old, I had won the Texas Heavyweight Wrestling Championship at a very young age. Within a three-day period of time in the old two-out-of-three-fall format, a man called Fred Von Erich beat me two straight, and the rest was history. And I haven't seen that time since, except to look at it.
Got the two count on Disco Inferno. We are seeing him.
But he never was. Three times. World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion.
No, yeah.
Here, Chetlock now from Prince Iaukea, and this is a definite new attitude for Prince Iaukea. We are seeing a very vicious man inside that ring, not the technical wrestler we have seen over the last couple of years, Mike.
I think the realization finally set in that the Prince needs to have more of an attitude if he's going to compete on this level. Here's the backslide.
Can he hang on? Disco kicked out at two.
Oh. That was a hard knock right there. Let me give you another little insight right here. I think the hottest team in WCW right now is Saturn and Chris Benoit. And I know that they are facing an uphill odds with former two-time World Heavyweight Champion Dallas Big, Bam Bam Bigelow. Now throwing Canyon in the mix once again. What do we see? We see a group of guys getting together saying, hey, this is the way it's going to be. This is going to be a long, hot summer here at WCW.
And of course, the inherent advantage with the triad, with the East Coast attitude, the Jersey boys, is the fact that they can maneuver around, they can manipulate, and the opponents don't really know which two of the three members will be involved in those tag team matches.
Swing and neckbreaker got the two count. Disco Inferno on Prince Iaukea. There is a lot of fight left in both of these athletes. Up top, in front of the atomic drop, stood the Prince up, the clothesline knocked him down. Quickly over, lateral press, hook the leg, Disco got the two.
Boy, it is great to see these arenas so packed in full when WCW comes along. You read off a list of places where we're going to be. I can't wait to Monday Nitro when we go in. Big party going on in New Orleans in the Superdome. What will happen with Sid Vicious and Macho when we get that CM Sting involved in that situation with Big Sexy Kevin Nash? I'm looking forward to it. Oh,
he missed him. The springboard body splash did not connect. There it is. The last dance from the Disco Inferno. That may very well do it. Hooks the leg and he got it. Disco Inferno with the last dance. That is a hard-fought victory here on Saturday night.
Well, it's all about taking advantage of an opening. And the Disco Inferno saw Prince Iaukea go up to the top rope. Attempted a springboard. He committed himself. And once he committed himself in midair, Disco was ready to turn the tide in his favor, and he hit the last thing.
I tell you what, that one was so jam-packed full of action. Let's make this one our Milky Way replay of the week. This replay is brought to you by Milky Way, introducing the best caramel ever in the new best ever Milky Way. Milk it, take it, Dream.
Well, you see it right there. Got hit in the back when you're talking about Milky Way. Right here, bad mistake. Got this. Disco Inferno right now taking a look. Once again, another mistake. Two mistakes. One match. Going to come back to haunt you right here. Disco taking advantage of this. And I guarantee you, when you talk about Milky Way, well, you can tell from my stature, I've had a few of them lately.
Ooh. That's our Milky Way replay. And when we come back on Saturday night, the cruiserweight strap is on the line.
All right, a very quick reminder here on Saturday night, World Championship Wrestling traveling across the country from coast to coast and border to border. Nashville, Tennessee, get ready. WCW in your great city on Friday night, July the 23rd at the Municipal Auditorium. Tickets on sale at the box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets. Next Friday, you can meet the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, at the Auditorium. In Little Rock, Arkansas, the date, Saturday night, July the 24th at Barton Coliseum. Tickets go on sale this Friday at the Fairgrounds box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets. Down in Jackson, Mississippi, Sunday night, July the 25th, Mississippi Coliseum, World Championship Wrestling, back in your great city. Tickets on sale at the box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets. By the way, this coming Friday, you can meet Hacksaw Jim Duggan at the Coliseum. Memphis, Tennessee, Monday Nitro on July the 26th at the Mid-South Coliseum. Tickets available at the box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets Friday. You get to meet the Nitro Girls in Memphis. Plus, get ready. This Saturday, tickets go on sale in Sioux Falls, South Dakota for Monday night, August the 2nd, WCW Monday Nitro in Sioux Falls at the arena. Tickets available starting next Saturday at the box office and at all Ticketmaster locations. Colorado Springs, Monday, August the 16th, Nitro at the World Arena. Tickets go on sale next Saturday at the World Arena box office and at all Colorado neighborhood box office locations. WCW, Monday Nitro, coming to your town live in the near future. Be part of it.